Hey guys, welcome to your sunshine yoga flow. We are in beautiful Kawartha Lakes, and I've got a flow for you that's gonna get your body moving and feeling amazing. We're gonna get the blood flowing, get you stretching and lengthening the whole body. I want you to remember to breathe, to hold the poses, and really enjoy this flow. So grab your mat, your water, and let's do it. All right, guys, so we're gonna begin today in a seated position on your mat. Your feet together, your knees together. Just take a second to take a deep breath in. Exhale out, reaching the arms up to the sky. And then slowly coming your way over to your child's pose. Just take a second here to relax, reaching the arms forward. And then when you're ready, slowly come on over to your hands and knees position, taking your cat-cow. Inhaling as you arch the back, look up. Exhale as you round the spine. Back into neutral. Tuck your toes underneath. And we're going to take our time here, coming into a downward facing dog. First, keep your knees bent. Just feel it out and then slowly start to extend. And just see how far you can go. You don't have to go to a full extension. Just feel that stretch in the back of the legs and then slowly start to add a little walk. Moving one knee, one leg at a time. Very nice. Just keep breathing, allowing your sternum to fall a little closer towards the mat. Allow both heels to fall away from you. Let them sink into the ground. Deep breath in. Exhale, slowly rounding forward through each vertebra of your spine into plank position. Taking our flow here, Chaturanga Dandasana when you're ready. And upward facing dog. And exhale, downward facing dog. Beautiful. Just take a moment here and breathe. And then stepping forward to the very top of your mat. Hanging out here in our forward fold, allowing all the tension to release from the shoulders, from the neck. And then taking your hands, interlacing behind your back, and allow the hands to fall forward, giving the shoulders a nice stretch. And remember, you always fold from the hips, not the lumbar spine. Wonderful. Slowly roll yourself back up and coming into our standing cobra. Keep those hands interlaced. Open the chest, open the heart. And then bending the knees, coming back down into that forward fold. Beautiful. Just take a deep breath in. Extend the knees if you can. And slowly come back up to center your Tadasana. Inhale, reaching the arms up. Exhale, hands down to heart. Inhale, one more reach. Exhale, swan dive to the floor, forward fold. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, step or jump back into plank position. Chaturanga Dandasana, upward facing dog, inhale. And exhale, downward facing dog. Beautiful, take a second here. Deep breath in, exhale, stepping forward back to the top of your mat, rounding up to your standing position, taking another breath in, reach the arms, exhale, hands to heart, one more, deep breath in, reach up, exhale, swan dive all the way back down to your mat, inhale, halfway, exhale, this time we're going to step our right leg all the way back into your lunge position. Take a second here, just find your balance, find your center. And as soon as you're ready, you're going to reach both arms up into your high lunge. Staying here, allowing your body to sink a little deeper into this posture. Beautiful, inhale. Exhale, bring the hands back down And then from here, reaching your left arm up to the sky into your reverse side angle. Stacking those shoulders on top of each other. Reaching for the sky. And then slowly release, pivoting the back foot and taking your extended side angle. Reaching those right fingers up to the sky. See if you can look up towards that hand. And then slowly come back to center. Let's do that one more time. Reverse side angle, left arm up. Hold and breathe. And releasing the hand, pivoting the back foot, extended side angle. Now this time, if you like to go a little bit further, see if you can reach that top arm all the way to the very top of your mat. So feeling that long lengthening stretch across your whole body. Wonderful. Slowly coming up to your warrior two. Deep breath in, turning the palm and taking your peaceful warrior. Allowing yourself to come all the way back, making sure the front knee stays over top of the ankle. Coming back to center, deep breath in, exhale, taking your extended side angle one more time. Again, go a little further into this pose. Feel that nice lengthening stretch. And slowly up. Warrior two, extending the front knee, flex your feet. And then slowly from here, taking our wide-legged forward fold. A slight pigeon toe on the feet. See if you can grab your ankles. And then your goal here is to try and get that forehead as close to the ground as possible. And just breathing here, letting go into this posture. Slowly, let's take a twist. So your left hand is going to reach for that right ankle. You're going to reach the right arm up. Hold and breathe. Trying to keep your hips square. Simply follow that top arm with your eyes. Other side, same thing, reaching for the ankle. Other arm reaches up to the sky. Holding here and breathing. Feeling that nice stretch through the hamstring. Beautiful job. Coming back to center, wide-legged forward fold, bending the knees, and slowly make your way back up. Inhale, reaching the arms up to the sky. Exhale, pivoting your right foot this time, so opposite leg, coming into your warrior two. So we're just reversing everything onto the other leg. From here, take a deep breath in, and then exhale, take your extended side angle. Reaching that top arm to the very top of your mat. And slowly come back up, and then taking your peaceful warrior. Sinking down into that posture, letting go of any tension in the body, focusing on your breath. Deep breath in. Exhale, come back to center. Let's do that one more time. Extended side angle. Reaching that top arm. Lengthening out that entire side of your body. Beautiful. Come back over. Now pivoting the back foot and then taking your right arm up into your reverse side angle. Hold hold it here, finding your breath, continuing to reach up towards the sky, and then releasing the hand, pivoting the back foot, extended side ankle. Now this time you can keep your arm up, or you can reach to the top of your mat again if you wish. And slowly release, turning the back foot one more time, reversed side angle. Hold, see if you can go a little bit deeper with your hips. Wonderful. Coming back to center, square off your hips, and when you're ready, taking your body up into your high lunge. Breathe, allowing those hips to sink down, opening the chest, opening the heart. And slowly come on up, extending the front knee, turning the toes back over to the center. And this time we're going to turn the toes out, heels in, and take our yogic squat, allowing the knees to point outward, and then see if you can reach the arms up to the sky, opening the heart and the chest. Beautiful, just stay there, breathe. And slowly come on up, reaching both arms right over towards your heart, releasing the shoulders, and then turning over to the front of your mat. Inhale, reach up to the sky. Exhale, forward fold down. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, step or jump into plank position, hold it here. Chaturanga Dandasana, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Take a moment here. Give yourself a little bit of a break. Allow the sternum to come all the way down. Breathe, let go. Going deeper with each exhale. When you're ready, we're going to go into our one-legged dog. So you're going to reach one leg up, bending the knee, flexing that top foot, and just holding here for a moment. Feeling the stretch in the quad, in the hamstring. Wonderful. And then taking that top foot and stepping into the very top of your mat, but slightly over to the side. We're going to prepare for a lizard posture today. So you're going to stay here. And when you're ready, you're slowly going to bring both elbows onto the mat. Now, if this is too difficult, you're more than welcome to just stay with your hands on the floor. You can also take your back knee all the way down to make this a little easier. And then think about rolling that outside foot to the lateral side, so the pinky toe area of your foot, allowing that knee to fall away from you as you let go deeper into this posture. Focusing on the breath, and then slowly come on up. Stay here, go ahead and bend that back knee, and then see if you can grab that ankle. As soon as you grabbed your foot, just start to bring the heel closer towards your body. This is an amazing stretch for the quadricep. Now don't worry if you can't grab your foot, just try your best, try just bending it for now. Release, come back to center, tuck your back toes, lift the back knee, hold, and then slowly step right into plank position, holding that plank, finding your breath. Inhale, exhale, take your Chaturanga Dandasana, upward facing dog, and exhale, downward facing dog. Wonderful. Just take a second for yourself. And then whenever you're ready, reaching your other leg up, bending the knee, stacking the hips if you wish. Hold. is slowly stepping that foot to the very top of your mat and just slowly walking it to the very right side, coming down into that lizard. So again, you guys, you have a couple variations here. You can stay up, you can come on down to your elbows, or you can also drop that back knee to the floor. Now when you got to that position, start to roll the foot to the lateral side, allowing the knee to fall away from your body. An incredible stretch for the hips. Just finding your breath here. Inhale. Exhale. Slowly come on up. Find your center. You can bring that foot down if you wish, and then bending the back knee and just see if you can grab it. Again, just do your best. No worries if you can't grab the foot, just bend the knee. Awesome. Let go of your foot. Come on down into your lunge position, lifting the back knee, and then stepping over into our plank position one more time. Let's hold that plank. Really engage the core muscles here. Inhale, pulling the belly button right into the spine. Inhale again. Exhale out, Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhale, Upward Facing Dog. And exhale, Downward Facing Dog. Holding that Downward Dog position, finding the breath. Allowing the heels to sink even deeper into the ground. And when you're ready, hop on over to the top of the mat, and then we're gonna make our over to the floor. So the next postures are butterfly. So you're just gonna bring the feet together, knees open, and then allow your body to simply fall forward, breathing and letting go. Taking another deep breath in, and then exhale, come on up to center. Bring the knees together. Go ahead and extend both legs all the way out. Inhale up again, and then exhale, taking your seated head to toe forward fold. Now I always like to stress this for you guys. Make sure you bend from the hips. Please do not bend from your lower back. You want to keep your back healthy and strong here. Beautiful. Now if you'd like to go a little bit further, you can try and grab your big toes. Continuing to bring your forehead down towards the knees. Come on up. And then release the hands over to your heart. Inhale. Exhale. One more reach up on your inhale. Exhale. Come on down to the floor. So relax, go ahead and bring both knees into your chest and take a gentle rock side to side, massaging the sacrum. Wonderful, and reaching the one arm over your head, rolling over to your fetal position on your side, and then coming up to your seated position on your mat. Cross the feet in front. Just take a second here, take a couple of deep breaths in. Reach the arms up to the sky. Palms together, and then slowly bring the hands over towards your heart or towards your third eye. Staying here for a moment, bring all that positive energy towards your body, towards your soul. And thank yourself for the most wonderful practice today and for taking this time for yourself. Lots of love, you guys, and I can't wait to see you again. Namaste. Don't Don't forget to follow us on social media, our Facebook, Instagram, and if you haven't subscribed yet, feel free to subscribe to our channel for more fitness, yoga, and lifestyle videos. See you soon.